Philippine security officials seek more details of a supposed deal by then-President Rodrigo Duterte with China. Duterte's former spokesperson claims Manila's violation of this agreement provoked China's violent actions in the West Philippine Sea. Katrina Domingo has tonight's top story.
A status quo agreement in the West Philippine Sea was forged between former President Rodrigo Duterte and Chinese leaders during the previous administration. This is what former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque confirmed when he tried to explain what prompted Beijing's use of water cannons against Philippine vessels within Manila's exclusive economic zone.
Hey, nagkaroon kasi ng gentleman's agreement. No? Ito'y oral sa panahon ni pa Presidente Duterte na ang parehong panig, ang China at Pilipina, ay re-respectuhin ang status quo. Ibig sabihin, kung ano yung naroon na walang dagdag, walang bawas. At dahil dito sa agreement nito, sa tingin ko, nabawasan yung tensyon sa panig ng Pilipinas at ng China. Dumating yung Chinese Premier sa Pilipinas ng panahon ni Duterte at dumating din si President Xi mismo sa Pilipinas. So marami pagkakataon talaga na nakapagpulong ang presidente, hindi lang sa ambassador, hindi lang sa foreign minister ng China, kundi sa premier at saka kay President Xi dito sa Pilipinas, sa China, at sa iba-iba pang venue.
Roque says aside from him and Duterte, the past administration's foreign and executive secretaries were also privy to what he describes as a gentleman's agreement between Manila and Beijing. Despite the arrangement, China launched a water cannon attack against a Philippine resupply vessel near the Ayungan Shoal in 2018. Roque says the move angered the Davaoenia leader, and Chinese officials who were summoned to explain the incident noted that they were upset over the ferrying of construction materials to repair the BRP Sierra Madre, a decades-old grounded warship that serves as the Philippines' lone outpost in the Ayungan Shoal. Roque clarifies that contrary to China's recent claim, Duterte never agreed to tow the BRP Sierra Madre away from its location. Chinese officials earlier alleged that Duterte had also agreed that only a lone resupply vessel will ferry basic supplies to Philippine troops aboard the grounded warship.
So dun sa usapin na yun, lumabas na kaya nila winater cannon, eh kasi ang kasunduan ng status ko, hindi dapat magpapadala ng mga materials for repair nung Sierra Madre.
Okay.
Na matapos naman yung incidenting yun, wala nang ganyang incidenting nangyari. Wala pong naging kasunduan na tatanggalin ang Sierra Madre sa Ayungin. Okay. Ang kasunduan, papayagan nilang dalhan ng tubig at pagkain, hindi nila haharangin.
The National Task Force West Philippine Sea says Roque needs to further explain details of the agreement as it may be a violation of the Philippine sovereignty. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya also underscores that the Marcos Jr. administration cannot be pushed to honor Duterte's deal with China as it is not legally binding.
We have not seen any document. We have not seen any report that there was such an agreement. And as mentioned by President Bongbong Marcos himself, if ever there was one, he has repudiated it.
The Foreign Affairs Department also wants more explanation as to why the former administration allowed China to have a say in the Philippines' activities in the Philippines' own continental shelf and exclusive economic zone. For Roque, Duterte's deal with China did not trample upon the Philippine sovereignty.
Wala naman tayong soberenyang ginibap eh. Kasi pati naman yung Ayungin Shoal na yan, EEZ. Wala naman tayong soberenya sa EEZ. Sovereign rights lamang. Karapatan lamang na mangalap at syempre makinabang sa tanging yaman na makikita ron.
Meanwhile, the Philippines thanked over 20 countries that condemned China's illegal incursions and aggression in the West Philippine Sea that left several Filipino troops and scientists injured.
Very strong statements of support for the Philippine position, but you do not hear any country expressing support for China. No, you do not hear any country expressing support for what they're doing, the water cannoning of our troops, the injuries suffered by our servicemen. And you don't hear anyone coming to the defense of China saying that the 10-dash line is correct. So I think the support of the international community should send a signal to China that this is not the right path.
Malaya says the National Security Cluster has already submitted its recommendations on how to deal with China's violent tactics in the West Philippine Sea. He says President Marcos Jr. should be given ample time to study all options before deciding how the Philippines will move forward in dealing with China and its expansionist agenda. The president will travel to Washington, D.C. next month to attend a trilateral summit with U.S. President Joe Biden and Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. Malaya says while the leaders are expected to discuss trade and cybersecurity, the Philippines' maritime woes is high on the agenda. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.